Okay, so if you're using Google Docs, there's a couple different built-in ways to use navigation within your document. We're going to go over inserting links, and then we're also going to use bookmarks to use with those links. And the first type of link that we're going to go over is an internal link to another part of the document that's just generated by the structure of the document. And I'll show you what I mean. We want to link the day-to-day lives. Let's go to insert link to another part in this Google Doc, and it's already a heading. So we're going to left click on an arrow, and there's a header in my document that's called day-to-day lives. These other items are the first sentence in other paragraphs. I just filled it with Latin just so it wasn't distracting, but that's where these are coming from. But we're gonna select the header day-to-day lives. We're gonna click apply, and now you need to change it to viewing mode to get it to work. So now I'm acting as if I'm viewing this document, not creating it. And when I hover over day-to-day lives, you'll see that the cursor will change to the hand with the finger pointing out that indicates it's a link. If you left click on that, it'll bring you down to the section of the document that starts with this header. And that's all you need to do to link to a specific part of a document. But if you have a part of a document that you want to link to that is not the start of a section, we're going to do that. Let's just say we're going to come back to editing. We're going to highlight this sentence. I'm going to insert a bookmark. And it's done. You'll see the little image of a bookmark here. We're going to insert link. And now an option comes up for bookmarks. This wasn't here before because there were no bookmarks when I was looking for the headings. We'll select a bookmark, left click on the arrow to drop it down to expand bookmarks to see which ones are available. Right now we just have one. And we'll left click on that. So now this link is going to go to the bookmark that we just created. Let's click apply to put it in the document. We'll go back to viewing. And we're going to hover over more about their habitats. Left click on it brings me right to that bookmark. So that's two different ways to control where internal links go to in your document. Another type of link is an outside link. We're going to change it to editing. Let's link to allturtles.com, but we're going to mistakenly think that it's just turtles.com. We're going to go to insert link. And Google's going to search for turtles.com but not find it. So it's going to suggest allturtles.com. Let's just think, oh yeah, it should have been that. So let's left click on allturtles.com. It fills out the entire web address of allturtles.com. You're going to see turtles, but it's going to link to allturtles.com. So we actually need to go in and correct this link and say allturtles.com and apply it. And let's get rid of this little all here just by deleting those three letters. And now you have an external link to a website. So let's change this to viewing and see how this works. So scroll back down to it, find it. We're going to left click on it. And what it'll do is just launch another browser window and bring you to allturtles.com. If I'm using Mac, it might use Safari. If I'm using Windows 10, which I'm using here, but if I have my default browser set to Edge, it's going to bring it up in that. All it is a link, and your system's going to determine how it looks at it. And the last type of link that I'm going to show you is a link to another Google document. In this case, it's going to be a Google Sheet. So we have some data in a spreadsheet here that I want to link to. We're going to go over to the spreadsheet that I'm talking about. And let's just say it's this range. Really not about turtles. Let's just say it is. And we want to scroll down to get a link to this range. Left click on that. It's going to paste it to your clipboard. Come back to your Google Doc. Switch back to editing. Got to re-highlight this data in the spreadsheet. Go to insert link, and in this case, we're going to just paste it in with the control V where it says paste the link. And it will be the link to that Google Sheet, and within that Google Sheet, the specific range. If you can actually see it in the URL right there, if you look closely, we'll click apply and go back to viewing. come back in here as if we're the reader. We're going to left click on the data in the spreadsheet, and it's going to bring them to that range in this Google Sheet. So they'll see exactly what you're talking about. It takes a while to load, but it's on my screen now, although it still says working. And the range that you link to is going to be highlighted. So you're going to show the reader exactly what you want to show them. So those are several different types of links that you can do, and using bookmarks for some of them. If you find that tutorial helpful and you want to see others like it, you can subscribe to my channel in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.